Hi, my name is Margaret Schmidt, and I am a program manager for Microsoft Project. I've worked on the Microsoft Project team for about a year and a half, and I specialize in scheduling and accessibility. And today I'm going to talk to you about how you can leverage calendars and resources to schedule your project in Microsoft Project for the web. So just a little overview of our agenda today. First, we're going to talk about calendars and how to create them and apply them in Project for the Web. We're going to talk about the different resources that we have that you can make in Project for the Web. And then we're going to bring it all together to build an accurate schedule in Microsoft Project. So we're going to do all of this during a demo today, but I'm just going to set up that demo a little bit. So this demo is going to focus on Lucy, who is a worker for a nonprofit in the Seattle area. And the project she is working on right now is she is creating a float for an upcoming parade in Seattle. So there are a few things that Lucy needs to do to make sure that this project happens on time. First of all, she needs to rent tools to help her build the parade float. Her organization doesn't actually own any, so she wants to rent them and be able to track when those are available. The second thing is she has some volunteers who work with the organization, and she wants to be able to manage when they are available and what type of work that they are doing. And the last thing is she wants to track her own hours and the hours of her coworkers who are also working on this project so that their managers are aware of everything that they are doing. So let's jump into the demo. So now I've opened up Microsoft Project for the Web and I'm on the homepage. And Lucy has already created a parade float project down here. So we're going to open that up. Lucy has already added a bunch of tasks in here, and I opened up the timeline view. Now, as you can see, we have actually these grayed out columns, which represent the weekends here. And if I try to drag a task onto a weekend day, it automatically gets rescheduled to the next working day. And we have a toast down here that tells me that. But Lucy actually wants to be able to work on weekends. You know, she's working with volunteers on this project, which means that sometimes people are going to want to come in on Saturday. So Lucy needs to make sure that weekends are available during this project. And the way she does that is first by going to project settings. Now, as we can see here, there isn't any calendar information. This tells Lucy that she actually needs to go talk to her admin and ask them to create a project calendar for her. So I'm going to open up the admin user. Now, this is the admin user, and Lucy has asked her admin to create a 7-day-a-week calendar for her. So I'm going to teach you how to do that. The admin has opened up Power Apps and is going to go to Apps, and then once that loads, go to Project. And then when they're on the project, they're going to go to Resources. So what the admin is actually going to do is they're going to create a resource with the right amount of working hours and then create a calendar based on that. So I clicked New here, and I'm going to click resource type. Now there are a bunch of types, and we're going to talk about some of these later on in the presentation. But for now, I just need a generic resource, which just means, you know, unspecified. If you don't need any of the other types, you should probably make a generic resource. I'm going to name this something like 7-day-a-week calendar. Now, this is a resource, so that might seem a little odd, but we're going to set the calendar of this resource. So that's going to make sense in a little bit. After this saves, what's going to happen is I'm going to get a new tab here called Work Hours. And when I click on that, it's going to open up and show me all of the working hours of this resource. Everything in Microsoft Project gets a default work hours template when you create it, which is usually Monday through Friday, 9 to 5, although it could be different based on your tenant. Now I've opened up the editing pane and I can add Saturday and Sunday as working days. Now I'm not going to actually mess with the times during which this resource works because Lucy's office is only open 9 to 5 every day anyways, but we have added Saturday and Sunday as working days so that this resource can work on those days. And as soon as I clicked save, we saw that those changes were updated on this calendar. So we're going to save and close this resource. Once that's been saved and closed, I'm actually going to go down here to Projects and click on Settings. This is going to give me a little bit different information. We don't really care about the parameters tab, but we're going to go to the calendars templates tab. Calendars templates are templates that define when your project can work. So we see that there's only one calendar template here, which is the default one. And this actually just represents the 9 to 5 Monday through Friday working hours that most things get assigned. But we're going to create a new calendar template here and call this the 7-day-a-week calendar and add a resource. So we can find our resource here and click Save. So now the resource whose working hours we updated has been applied to this work template. So now this work template has the working hours that were defined by this resource. Now I'm going to go back to Lucy and reload this project. So in this sense, the admin has created a new working hours template and told Lucy that they made a working hours template that she can use. So she's going to go back and try to apply that working hours template to this project. As soon as this loads, Lucy is going to reopen that project details pane. And we can see that at the bottom, now we have this calendar dropdown, which gives me different options for calendar templates I can choose. Lucy's going to choose the 7-day-a-week calendar and close that. And as soon as I did that, we saw that those grayed out columns disappeared. And now I can schedule my tasks for weekend days without them getting rescheduled, which is great. Now Lucy can schedule her tasks for whenever she wants. However, she still has to create a few resources to make sure that her tasks can be assigned to whoever she wants. Lucy can do that without the admin, so that's what I'll do now. I'm going to go into this waffle and open up Power Apps. Lucy's going to see something that's a lot like what the admin sees, but because Lucy isn't an admin, she isn't allowed to do everything that the admin can do, which is why we had to ask the admin to make the calendar. However, Lucy can make resources on her own. So she's going to go down to this resource page and wait for that to load and create some resources. So as we can see, there's actually I can see the 7-day-a-week calendar resource that the admin made. I'm not going to go edit this because I can't actually create new calendar templates. Now I'm going to create a new resource for Lucy. And the first thing Lucy wants to do is create an equipment resource. An equipment resource represents any type of equipment or piece of material that you might need to use for your project. So not a person working on tasks, but a thing that you might need to complete a task. I'm going to come down here and name this building tools and save that. So this represents the building tools that Lucy has rented to work on the parade float. And I can go in and edit the work hours of this just like I did with the generic resource. Now let's say that Lucy actually only rented this for the month of March. So I'm going to come in actually and edit this and following events. Now we can see that there's a start date here and there's an end date here, which is December 29th, 9,999. I'm going to actually have to return these before then, which is on March 31st, because Lucy is only renting these for the month of March, and adding Saturday and Sunday as working days and saving. As soon as that's updated, I can see that when I go into the month of March, the tools are available on Saturdays and Sundays. So now that I've created the building tools, I'm going to create a resource for the volunteer. So to do that, I'm going to create a contact resource. A contact represents anyone who isn't part of your organization and who doesn't need access to project, but who the project manager wants to track. So in this example, you have a volunteer who doesn't actually need to know the entire scope of what's happening to build the float, but who Lucy needs to track because she needs to know when he is available and when he's going to be doing some work. So the name of this contact is Christopher Reed. And we also have to create a contact here. So I'm going to create new contact. And as you can see, there's a lot of information in here, but we only need the last name and the first name. So I'm going to create a contact, click save and close. And after that is saved, I can save my new resource. And again, once I've saved the resource, I can edit their work hours. Now, Christopher probably has a full-time job that he works during the week, but he likes to work weekends. We're going to update his working hours to reflect that. So we're going to deselect all of Monday through Friday, but leave him as available on Saturday and Sunday because he's willing to come in whenever we need him. When we click save, we can see that, again, our resource hours are reflected in the work hours tab and go back. Okay, so now that I've created my two bookable resources, I also want to make sure that Lucy's own working hours are up to date. So I'm going to scroll down and I find Lucy Martinelli here. While this is a user resource, she can come in and update her own working hours. So a user resource represents someone who's actually in your organization who has a license to project and has working hours. So when we scroll down, we can see that Lucy has already updated her working hours because she's working Saturday and Sunday during the month of March while this project is happening. Great, now I have all of my resources ready, and so I'm gonna go back to this waffle and hit all apps and scroll down until I find project. So now I'm back on the project for the web home, and I'm gonna reopen my parade float project. And it's back to where I left it. And you can see that Lucy has already added a group here with her coworkers who are gonna work on this project with her, but we can see that we don't have our building tools or Christopher resource in this group. That's okay. We can still assign those things to different tasks. So for example, for build float platform, I'm gonna click here and up, I can see that building tools has already been added here, but if I didn't see it, I could search for it and it appears under other team resources and everything else. So I'm gonna add that to my build float platform task and to my build skirt platform task. Now I know Christopher is walking in the parade, so I'm gonna add him to the prep parade walkers task. So I'm gonna search for his name and he appears right now under other team resources. So he's getting added there. And I'm gonna also add him to the walk and parade task. Now, as we can see, the effort got automatically updated to reflect how long we're gonna be using all of these different resources. So even though Christopher can't see when he is walking, we know that he's gonna spend about 8 hours on this, on these different tasks. And same with the building tools, we're gonna use them overall for about 72 hours. Of course, if I think that's wrong, I can come in here and edit them, but right now I think that's fine. Additionally, you know, Lucy can use her different team resources to assign them to tasks. So maybe Brooke is gonna mount it on wheels and Benjamin is going to hook up the lights and sound system. And we can see again that these effort fields are getting automatically updated. Now, maybe Benjamin, you know, has the default work calendar as all resources are given by default. The project has a Saturday through Sunday calendar. So we can actually see that, when this is happening over the weekend, Benjamin isn't getting any more work because it's assumed that all of his work is happening on the day that he can actually work, which is that working day, either Friday or Monday. So that's kind of why it's important to go in and set your calendars, because we have to make sure that our resources and our projects have similar calendars so that they can be scheduled on the correct days. Now, Lucy has a little bit more work to do in here, but I think we've seen all we really need to see to understand this. So let's get back to the presentation. So now that you've seen how calendars and resources work in project, tell us what you think. If you're watching this during the project conference time, check out the website and see if there are any upcoming resources roundtables to give us feedback on this experience. Additionally, we have a scheduling session which shows you how dependencies, constraints, and effort and duration work in project. If you want to understand a little bit more about those different things, I recommend you check out that session. And then the last thing is you can always send us feedback using our in-app feedback button, which is a little smiley face in the top right corner of the project app. So make sure if you go in there that you leave your email so that we can email you back if we have any questions or concerns about the piece of feedback you leave us. And that's it. Thanks so much for watching.